Alrighty, I am back with Fallout 3, baby. Try to go to a boardy. I'm trying to go to a bar, I think. I think it's over here. I hope so. Yep, I think it's over here. I think it's in here. Yep, let's get it.
Come on, you piece of junk.
Hey there.
Looking for my father, middle-aged guy. Maybe you seen him?
Yeah, I remember that man. I saw him talking to Moriarty. It's hard to forget handsome men like that.
Look, if you need more information, or point me in the right direction.
Yeah, I'll help you. Then Moriarty kicks my sweet ass out the door. Sorry, kid. If you want to know more, Moriarty is the only one who's gonna help you. Talk to Gob. He hates Moriarty more than I do. Maybe he'll tell you something, but I doubt it.
How much for a room? How much is for a room?
Well, for you, a room and some company will run you 120 caps up front.
Yeah, I see. Oh.
Well, you aren't gonna get very far with no money.
We'll store with the group.
Who, Gob? Well, if you can get past how he looks, he's a sweetheart. Colin's awfully hard on him, though.
Where did he come from?
He don't talk about it much, but apparently there's a whole city of ghouls somewhere down in D.C. He's mentioned his mother a couple of times, but other than that, he won't really say. He's been here for, I guess about 15 years now. Ever since Moriarty bought him off those slavers.
Do you ever, work with him?
With Gob? Well, he's sweet, and I know that he'd like to. It's just, I don't want to sound shallow or anything. I mean, I'm a whore. My standards aren't exactly high. But there are places even I won't go. Johnnies that are squishier than me are one of them.
Why is Moriarty so hard on him?
Well, the miserable bastard is hard on all of us. But Gob gets it the worst. I guess just because he's different, you know? Sure thing, baby. What did you have on your mind?
So what does it take to hire you?
It takes you renting a room. Sleep in it or don't. I don't care. I get paid either way. Huh?
Yeah, what are you saying about radio station?
You mean why was Gob banging on that radio? Well, out there in the wastes, there are two stations that broadcast. There's the Enclave station. I don't know who they are, but I think it might just be some pre-war broadcast on a loop or something. And there's Galaxy News Radio. It's run by a guy named Three Dog, somewhere down in D.C., but the signal went down a while ago.
Hmm. What's all this about gas and news radio?
You serious? Oh, you must have come from that vault, right. It's the only free radio station left in the wasteland. The guy who runs it, Three Dog, he's like the only person who seems to give a shit. He keeps talking about fighting the good fight or something. Better than the crap on the other station.
What's what around town, though?
I couldn't tell you, really. I talked to Manya, if you care that much. She's lived in Megaton longer than anyone.
I have to go now.
Take care of yourself, hun.
I will.
It is the same damn name.
I don't recognize you. New Lucy. In town or something?
Maybe we'll know.
I do. I'm looking for someone to make a delivery. Interested?
Sure, why not?
Great. I'd like you to deliver this message to my family in the Arafu settlement. I haven't heard from them in months, and I'm worried. As soon as you get there, talk to Davis West. He'll be glad to pay you for the trip.
Hey, okay. Can you give me some information about that?
Sure. Be glad to, since you're doing me a big favor and all.
Do you suspect your family's in danger?
No, not really. Maybe my letters just aren't arriving. Whatever you can do to get it there would sure be appreciated.
Who else lives in...
Well, let's see. There's Evan King. He's like the sheriff of the town or whatever. Then there's my family, the Ewer family. And a lady who lives alone named Karen Shenzi.
Where's Arfu?
Arfu is northwest of Megaton, on an old overpass over the Potomac. If you follow what's left of the river, you can't miss it.
Okay.
Okay.
I have to go now.
Hey, thanks again for doing this for me. It means a lot.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave station comes in fine. It's Galaxy News. Their signal's been shit lately.
I really hope you're not thinking of breaking into there.
Is that...
Hell of a day, isn't it?
Come on.
Well, hot damn. Someone new. Always a pleasure. Name's Billy Creel. You call me Billy, all right? I know Megaton looks more like a boneyard than a town, but it ain't all bad. Take me and Maggie, for instance. We make do just fine. I trade the stuff I scavenge, and she helps keep me on the straight and narrow.
Know anything about the area outside Megaton?
All I know is that I spent too much time out there, and beyond that, I ain't gonna talk about it.
I'm sorry, who's Maggie?
Oh, sorry. I guess I got ahead of myself, huh? Maggie's 9. Sweetest little girl you'd ever care to meet. We take care of each other. I ain't never had a daughter, but if I did, I'd want her to be Maggie. I took her in when her parents got killed by raiders. That was 2 years ago. It was a pretty bad scene. Small settlement up north. I'd stopped in to trade some salvage, and the whole place had been wiped out. I found Maggie hiding under a bed in the same room where her parents had been butchered. We've been together ever since.
What can you tell me about
Megaton? Megaton is the best little town you'll find in the Capital Wasteland. Don't let anyone tell you different. Strong walls, strong people, and strong booze. We've got everything you need to make a life these days. Catch you later.
Come on, man.
Work. Come on, work. Boy. Oh. Hey, Smoothskin. Do you need something? A drink, maybe? Anything? Anything
Not
at all?
Not really. Not really. What are you, though?
Haven't you ever seen a ghoul before?
No, what's it? Wait, is it ghoul?
Well, not all of us got the chance to hole up in a nice cushy vault when the bombs fell. A bunch of us got stuck out here in the world and got a full-on blast of heat and radiation. turned us into a pack of walking corpses. Near as I can tell, we age slower than you. A lot slower. There were even a few ghouls that were alive during the war. Of course, with a face like ground Brahmin meat, you can imagine that folks don't take too kindly to us. Yeah, fuck you too. Whatever, man. I'm used to being treated like shit around here.
I'm looking for my father. You know where?
Even if I knew, I wouldn't tell you.
A place called Underworld. It's a ghoul city down in D.C. I set off up here to find adventure and fortune. And, well, I found this place.
I'm sort of stuck here. Colin says that I can't leave until I pay off my debt to him. Of course, he charges me room and board, too. If you ever get to Underworld, tell Carol that I said hi.
All right, goodbye, my good
son. Don't hit me.
Hey, that's the call, hey, from back in the day. Hey, yeah, just a youngin' with a dream, trying to get this money, yeah, I'm trying to.